Hello everybody, welcome to a new episode of How to DYLC to the EC58 Weight Carry Challenge. How to see how much weight it can carry for the different FPV systems that we have, of course. And of course, we would like to use the Runcam Swift, the normal Swift. It is the heaviest, that weighs 20 grams. And then with the VTX, it weighs 25 grams. And then with the extra battery, it's going to be 30 to 35 grams. And that we would like to be a nice target to carry with the E58 without any problems. But it's going to be a test. Maybe if that doesn't fail, they have to go back to the like a micro Runcam. I lost my micro Runcam. It's up in a tree, as some of you subscribers know. This is a good replacement for it. This is very similar. And that weighs about 10 grams. And then with the VTX, it's 15 grams. And then with the battery, it's 20 grams. So it will still good fly with 20 grams. Micro Runcam is not so bad. Gives you still pretty good video quality over this simple all-in-one CCD camera, or CMOS camera, of course. That weighs only 5 grams, and then with the battery it's 10 grams. I'm almost pretty sure it can carry that, but we would prefer to have a better video quality. So let's test. Go ahead. To add some weight to the EC58, I got gas protons that weigh 21 grams each, and I got two of those, that is together 42 grams, and then an extra gram for the rubber band. And I got some 20 cent euro coins that weighs 5 grams a piece, so we can add more or get that really nice precise, almost precise figure. And let's connect the EC58 first. Let us get it trimmed out, making just sure it flies pretty okay. Then let's add the heaviest. Yeah, we're going straight for the heaviest that we can. Oh, I can add extra coins, but let's go for the 40 grams because this is the target I want to reach. So we are adding two of those gas protons, and now it's going to be pretty easy to pretty interesting to see if it can carry it. So oh, it's taking off 42 grams. Let's put it in higher rates. Okay, I need to trim it out. Oh, and she's going down. She's going down. Uh-oh. Oh, she can fly, but it is really troubling the drone. It's really, yeah. And it really needs that little bit of ground effect. The full battery to carry itself. Oh, it can carry itself. And that really impresses me, but it is not able to really fly. You're seeing it cannot hold the altitude. With every little difference we make, it drops down. Every corner we make, it dropping down a lot. So 42 grams is really the maximum of the maximum. Yes, it can carry it. Yes, it can lift off and stay in the air and fly there, but it's not recommended to fly like that. We have to take some weight off and see how good she flies with 21 grams. Will that make a big improvement? I guarantee you. 20 grams on such a light quadcopter makes a big difference. I'm just gonna trim it out a little bit. Well, not a problem. It can carry it without losing.
Whoa!
Without losing too much altitude. It does, of course, give some problems. It's not 100% perfect. But it's working a lot better with 21 grams than with 42 grams. 42 grams was way too heavy. 21 grams. That means I can run a Runcam Micro Swift without a really big issue. But there was still a slight, the heavy weight isn't really proper for this drone. It's just a brushless drone with not upgraded motors yet. So If we really want to fly with a normal Rankine Swift, we have to upgrade the motors, definitely. What are we going to do? Going to add more weight. Let's add a cone and see if it still can carry 25 grams of 26. And make it 30 straight away. Let's top that up, 30 grams. And let's see if it can carry 31 grams. Oh, it can still carry 31 grams. And fly reasonably okay. Yeah, I can fly with this. Not a really big problem. Pretty impressive. Come on. So 30 grams is still possible. That's interesting. That's more than I really thought. When I started seeing a fly with 40 grams, was really, really, really at that edge. No. Now we have added one more coin. This is 36 grams of thrust. Oh, it can hold altitude. It's dropping a little bit. But it also can be the battery that is getting empty, of course. But really there, you can see it, it needs that ground effect. It needs to be pushing away from a solid object to get a little bit more thrust to carry this weight. So 35 is too much. 20 grams, that is really nice, or lower than 20 grams. Then you have a still good flying E-Seam 58. So it's gonna be an all-in-one camera around 10 grams. Then you have a great performance. Or you go for a micro run cam for around 20 grams. And you have a little bit less performance but better video quality. And still have an okay flying drone. I really hope you like this video and give it a thumbs up because it's getting really noisy. I'm going to end it over here. And I hope you subscribe for the next upgrade that we're going to do to the E-Seam 58. And I want to say goodbye. Until next time.